Well, this is the time of the year we start watching the eastern tropical Atlantic with waves coming off the coast of Africa. And lo and behold, we do have a feature that we are monitoring right now out there in the eastern tropical Atlantic. There's a couple of things, though, that we watch for when we're looking for the future progress of a particular feature. This wave is encountering what we call a lot of dry air to the north. That's one strike against it. Strike number two is that it's at a fairly low latitude. Typically speaking, when you look at the tropics, you want to see a wave between 10 and 20 as it's coming off the coast of Africa. Then it usually takes that long curve towards the west-northwest or the northeast. So the bottom line for now is we're getting into the middle of August here. This is the time of the year where we start watching these waves come off the coast of Africa. Ocean water temperatures start coming up. We're at or above that critical 80-degree water temperature right now. And that's usually supportive for tropical development. And we're also coming into mid-August and September. That is the peak of our hurricane season. So we've had a quiet June and July for the first time in a couple of years. And many folks are probably thinking this is going to be a weak hurricane season. That's not the case. Don't let your guard down. And please don't get complacent. One of the things we always talk about is that when you get into August, September, and October, there's usually a ramping up effect that's going to be taking place. And lo and behold, the first signs are now beginning to take shape across the eastern tropical Atlantic. Now, one good piece of information that we do want to throw at everybody, we do think that the number of storms this year may be a little bit lower. That's because of El Nino. The folks at Colorado State University, Dr. Gray's team, they put out these hurricane forecasts for a couple of months down the road, have downgraded the hurricane outlook. And this is great. 10 named storms, 4 hurricanes as opposed to 5 from their last report, and 2 major hurricanes. So the news from that standpoint is good, but the bottom line is this. The eastern tropical Atlantic will get busy now over the next couple of weeks, and we want you to check back in right here on WESH.com and on WESH 2 News.